myself Dhru and he's Jai. We are here to present our presentation on APIs for OpenIDEX platform. So our main objective was creating registration APIs, course dashboard APIs, and organization dashboard APIs. The implementation was based on REST framework, returning JSON data, and authenticated with OAuth 2. So these many APIs we have created.
Registration 1.
One registration. Organization 3.
No. Get post. Get the data of registered users.
Means after posting something is returned, that is the registered user is returned.
No, if you want the data of particular ID user, you can get, or you can post the data of new user.
Means you can register a user on edX platform,
open
edX platform.
Create a user in open edX.
Yes. We have tried to cover the vulnerabilities. We can show that now.
Organization API. What is it?
Means in organization API there are a count of certificates, discussion forum activity, and grades. Three types of API are created. In this, the focus is that these APIs can be used by the organization. Suppose another
organization.
No, this.
No, only these only are all great APIs.
That is okay. So you are getting discussion forum?
Activity means for all courses of that organization. Count of certificate for all courses of that organization means the organization which you specify in API endpoints. And the third one is the grade of all students of all courses that we have created, so that these APIs can be extended on organization dashboard. Means another organization has courses on edX platforms and they want to access all their courses. Then they can just get a token, OAuth token from the OpenIDEX platform. Courses API, same functionalities, but courses wise, not organization wise. And in courses API, faculty wise also is given, so that this can be used on faculty dashboard. And also grading in courses APIs, grading policy of course structure of a course can be fetched by anyone, so that student can easily get that thing. Course structure, without enrolling in the course, you can see the course structure of any courses.
These are open APIs or secured?
Secured. Means currently all the APIs can only be accessed by authenticated users.
And
OAuth 2. It is provided on OpenIDEX platform.
And register API is only accessible by admin user. We have used password type. Password token, yes.
No.
Means you can get the client ID and client app from the admin, and you have the user on.
There is a registration API.
Yes.
No, registration API only accessible by admin.
Admin.
Only admin can register, because no one else can register a student on edX, open edX platform.
Because this bypasses the catch. You can create multiple users in one script, so we have to give the admin privilege. Only admin can
token.
Access it with his token. Only admin. He generates his token with OAuth 2. He wants to create multiple users.
Means the main purpose is, suppose we want a
requirement to integrate other people and single login and all those kind of funny things happen. Okay. Like enemy ICT they register. Okay. And currently that registration is actually carried there and all that. So I need to be able to generate user registration. That is the current thing. You register an email and the actual post happens in IIT Congress. Currently what they are doing is, we give them a list of some stupid things, email addresses. And somebody cuts and pastes and makes it an invitation post. Okay. Because I don't have a post there. I'm not allowed security reasons. That's why we have to do it like this. So that is the main problem, which can get addressed. I am not comfortable.
What is the database?
On OpenIDEX platform, MySQL and Mongo both are used. All the data.
MySQL.
Registration data. Only course structure and course discussion forum activity are stored in Mongo. Everything else is stored in MySQL.
So you have done all that.
Okay.
How
and
lines of code?
2000 each.
2000, 2500 years ago.
Okay. What is the testing?
Testing, we have blocked for post APIs, we have put validation everywhere
first,
for regex. So no invalid
first of all, we have not allowed any invalid thing.
That is security. What is the testing?
Testing.
What are the test data you used?
No.
For grade APIs, we had been provided production server data from IIT Bombay X platform, and we had tested it. And for that API, I had also recorded the time by using just what time it takes for a course with approximately 2,400 students, and number of units in that course was 6. So it took 2.5 minutes to compute all the grades.
Compute the grades?
Because we are displaying the grades. Grades, and this grades API can be displayed in between also, means the course is currently ongoing. Then only those grades are displayed for which the student has done the assignment.
The
so we have to compute the
grades
ourselves, not, we can't take from any table. So we tried that. Other all API we are directly taken from table, so that's
only,
right.
One
only grade API
computation.
Is a very high computation.
Direct query is there.
One is security, and is there any other risk?
We have also restricted one thing, that number of requests per user, that is provided by Django
REST. Requesting this,
means
continuously.
Means by chance a malicious user gets enrolled in the platform, and he tries to crash the server or anything by recursively calling the APIs. Then we have restricted that. So.
The serious API, even though I have the authentication, I can start spamming.
No, you
so
can spam only the post API.
Something like a CAPTCHA kind of thing, where the machine cannot do it. Okay, whether you have covered those credentials?
For
no.
Post API, the admin credentials are required, that you can keep secure.
For registration API, nothing is needed because only admin is allowed. So that. For other APIs, we have not yet.
We have blocked the user if he post
we have
more than
try, attempted to restrict things, but we have not used the CAPTCHA thing.
But if we request get
for restricting
get
automated requests, we have limited number of requests per user per minute.
Are you going to submit them in OpenEDX?
We have only taken dump of data and then tested it. We have not directly put it on a server because still.
No, you should not have allowed to put on the server.
Yes, that's why.
That is why I asked.
Yes.
Okay. The reason I am asking is that somebody has to do the gada work, na, whether it is good, bad, or ugly. Why should I? No, but only way this should come to us is through OpenEDX. Okay, we can test it and use it if you want, that is different, but that's still a risk. Okay, I would rather publish it to the whole world.
Yes, we have posted. Yes, added to installed apps. Yes,
we are doing the same procedure. Yes, that's how we have packaged it, that's how we have created a Django app, and all the we have specified on GitHub link is present. On this documentation there are installation links.
Models for
registration API models, for other APIs models are not used because Mongo is not a relational database.
Oh, there's a model store,
Yes. No, Django for MySQL table models can be created.
So you have created your own models of table?
No.
LMS models.
We are using
yes.
LMS
yes. Okay. We have used PyMongo for Mongo currently because we didn't.
So PyMongo is not a good way because that's the GitHub repository of the server, it will never allow you. See, that API, whatever you have to push something or take something, so you're creating a special connection for that.
Okay.
And every time you run your REST API, the connection is going over there. So it will cross more number of connections. But the movement is used to class engine by default.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
Because there is no proper documentation for vault data.
We have to search in GitHub. Okay. Okay. Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Go. Write.